Hey guys, and welcome back to the Gerbil Vine. Thank you so much to our growing number of subscribers. You guys are awesome. You all supporting the channel means so much to the Gerbils and I, and we really appreciate you guys helping us spread around good care here on YouTube. So if you haven't already, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button down below. Now, gerbils are super amazing small animals. We all know that. Along with other factors, one thing that really made me lean towards gerbils as pets was that they are able to be litter trained. If I'm being honest, there isn't a super huge amount of work that you put in on your part when sand training your gerbils. It's not like teaching your puppy to go outside or teaching your toddler to use the potty. It's a bit different. It's more like putting a cat in a litter box. Their instincts will just tell them that they will need to go to the bathroom and they'll just start doing what comes naturally to them. So gerbils are on the same page as cats in that sense. Gerbils are a semi-desert species of animal, and sand is a big natural part of their environment. If you've seen my other video on safe sands and soils, you'll know that not all sand that is sold in pet stores or online is safe for your gerbils to use, so you really do have to use your discretion and make sure that you are only buying calcium-free sand. When providing your gerbils with a sand bath, most owners tend to use like a large, deep dish or a jar or a bowl or something of that sort, because gerbils tend to kick bedding all over everything in their tank, and their sand bath will be no exception to that. Most people sort of section off their tank or put the sand higher up on either a platform or in their topper like I have behind me here, because this allows the sand to be contained so that it isn't wasted, because gerbils can also kick the sand out of these bowls and jars. So for the longest time I used like a deep ceramic planter bowl, and that worked really, really well. However, when I upgraded my gerbils to my topper recently, I found that they were going to the bathroom a lot along the platform, which wasn't really a huge issue because at least I could see it and I could clean it, so it was almost like it was easier that they were going there, but it was still sort of frustrating from a cleaning standpoint. So what I did was essentially make their sand bath. I don't know if you can see it in the back there. So it starts here and it goes all the way and ends right here. So it's quite a long sand bath and it covers majority of the platform space that they have. So I found that that's been really effective and efficient in holding their waste to use something longer and wider rather than taller and deeper, if that makes sense. Sand is really, really great for gerbils because it allows them to keep their coats looking clean and shiny. So it is a common misconception that rodents have little or no control over their bowels. Many different rodents have full control over their bladder and their bowels. They just like to go to the bathroom a lot. Gerbils are known for not having to go to the bathroom as much as other small rodents, such as rats or mice or hamsters, which is really great for you because it means that you don't have to clean as much waste every day. So while you don't need to train your gerbils to use the potty, there are some tips and tricks that you can use, and there are definitely some ways that you can encourage them to use their sand as a potty. Number one, leave their sand in at all time. If you really want your gerbils to associate a certain spot, in this case, their sand bath as a designated bathroom area, then this is something that they should have access to at all times. Taking the sand out can cause your progress to backtrack, as if the gerbils can't find their sand to go to the bathroom, they will just revert to going back in any old place. So imagine having to go to the bathroom and you gotta go really bad, you're running around looking for your bathroom, you go to the last place you remember your bathroom being in, poof, it's vanished and it's no longer there. You would end up finding another spot to go in. And if you keep repeating this process, sand training unfortunately won't have a chance to work. I'm not too sure why some people might have an issue with leaving their sand in at all times. Like I previously mentioned, gerbils will naturally know what to do with sand if you give it to them. It is a part of their environment in the wild, and it is something that I do consider to be a gerbil essential. I always leave my sand in and they always use it as a potty. Number two. The second tip to help sand train your gerbils would be to pick the perfect location. If you have sand that is constantly being filled up with bedding, or being kicked out, or getting wet from their water bottle, this likely isn't going to be a place where your gerbils are going to want to go to the bathroom. Making sure that you keep the sand free from debris is something that can be a bit challenging, particularly if you don't have a platform or a topper, but I did it for a very long time when I didn't have either of those things. I just made some sort of divider or barrier around it, and that was able to work well for the most part, and I have had success with that in the past, so it is something that is doable. So really, you can do it whichever way works best for you, but the location of the sand is very, very important. Also, to add on that, if there is a place in your tank where you notice your gerbils are going to the bathroom a lot, you can always try and move the sand to that location if for whatever reason they're not using the sand as a potty, and then you can see if that works. Tip number 3. You want to make sure that you are keeping the sand clean from their waste as well. While it's true that gerbils don't go to the bathroom as much as other small rodents, they still do go to the bathroom quite a bit. Here is some footage of me sifting through their sand, which I do every morning and every night. So from morning to now, this is all the waste that they've created. So it's not huge, but it does add up. When your gerbil pees in the sand, it will start to form a clump, and it will have an odor to it, which is why I decide to clean my sand 2 times a day, morning and night. What you doing? Why? No. Having a clean and nice smelling area will also make them want to use it more, at least more so than if it was wet, clumpy, and filled with waste. Number 4. So the final tip to help encourage your gerbils to use their sand bath would be to make the area by the sand exciting. Gerbils are very curious small animals, and if for some reason they are not using their sand on their own, you can try to spruce up their sand bath area to make it more exciting. Whether you decide to add a moss or a bendy bridge leading up into the sand, or whether you decide to have it covered, or whether you put a hide in there or above it, I do have a coconut hide right above my sand there that I do fill with treats from time to time, although my gerbils don't really need help using the sand. That's already a skill that they have, but I feel like it does help them because gerbils like to go to the bathroom where they eat and where they play. So if there's sort of like a play and eating area by their sand, it's likely that you can encourage them to use their sand that way. So that concludes our sand training tips. Like I mentioned earlier, gerbils don't really need much training when it comes to using their sand. This is a natural behavior of theirs, and they will just know what to do. There are many ways that you can encourage them to use the sand by keeping it clean, by making it fun, and by putting it in a good location. If you guys haven't seen my video on safe sands and soils, I will link it up in the iCard above, and you guys can go and check that out if you want to. As always, thank you so much for watching, and to those of you that comment, thank you so much for engaging in our growing gerbil community. Reading your comments really does make our day, so thank you guys so much. Don't forget to like and subscribe so that you never miss our uploads. Thank you. Bye.